has great leaping ability. He's not short, you know, but he's not tall, but he's got mad hops, as they say. So he's and most of his goals this year, a lot of his goals are on set pieces. He gets up. And then the second one was a ball that came back off of Jordan. I think Jordan hit it, and it come back, and then he hit it, and it just glanced off Jordan's hip. It changed directions. I was right in line with it. It changed directions just slightly, you know, and, you know, it was a thing of beauty.
After I shot that, I kind of knew that our defense would pull through with Jeremy Norwood and Drew and Greg Brenner. I mean, they're solid in the back. So once I scored that, I just kind of felt like our defense was going to hold us in. We have the greatest guys on this team. I mean, all those guys on there are, like, seriously, like my brother. I mean, we've got chemistry there. It's just that that's how well we play, you know. If the chemistry's there, I think we'll just find each other on the field, and that's how we play, and that's how far we've come.
You don't ever get tired of playing in a CIF championship game. You don't get tired of doing that, and that's why you play. You know, everybody's dream and goal is to win a CIF title. You know, league goals, league games, league championships are great, you know, but you kind of start at the top on your goals and you work down.
It's been a season of firsts for El Toro. First, they finish the regular season with 20 wins, and then they go undefeated at home, both school records. And now with a 2-1 victory over Loyola, they will advance to the Division I championship game, where they will face Milliken on Saturday. Today, it was all about Jacob Kaiser, the front runner for County Player of the Year, as he scored 2 goals, and he will lead his Chargers to the championship game. Reporting from El Toro High, I'm Jonathan Khamis for OCVarsity.com.